Hey, I'm Eric here. The ESP32 cam is simply a combination of the ESP32 and OV2640 lens module, so all functions of ESP32 are the same. Because the ESP32 cam is quite affordable, it's easy to try a variety of projects. This is a really strong point. But there are many known issues with this device, so you need to use them carefully. That's why many people don't like this device. Aside from the miscellaneous problems, today's project is to output the image sent from ESP32 cam on TTGO's display. You don't need a wireless network router here, because TTGO becomes AP mode and ESP32 cam connects directly through Wi-Fi. The source code used in this project can be downloaded via the link below. I hope it helps. Okay, let's get started. I have been working on various projects with ESP32 cam so far. If you are subscribing to my channel, I think you have seen it at least once. One of them is exactly the same as the project we are planning to do today except for the part where TTGO display. So ESP32 cam is not covered in this video. If you want to know more about how I use ESP32 cam and WebSocket, please watch the video above. It's a waste of time to deal with the same contents here. Thank you for your understanding. Please download the source code for the ESP32 cam through the link below. If possible, please install it in advance. Let's briefly talk about the way it works. The ESP32 cam operates in Wi-Fi station mode. It's trying to connect to the pre-selected target access point with a predefined SSID and password. When the Wi-Fi connection is established, it acts as a WebSocket client and continues to send images. This is what ESP32 cam does. It's very simple. Let's see how TTGO works this time. TTGO works like a server. The Wi-Fi operates in access point mode and waits for the client to connect. At the same time, the WebSocket server is opening. The client connected through Wi-Fi tries to connect to the WebSocket at this time. When the connection is established normally, the JPEG image starts to come in from ESP32 cam. After that, I'll put the image on the screen of the TTGO until one of the TTGO or ESP32 cam is disconnected. This is all about this system. It's pretty simple and intuitive. Here is the source code for TTGO. I'm gonna skip the TFT ESPi, TJPEG decoder, ESP32 Wi-Fi, and WebSocket. What I'm going to tell you in detail in this code is the incoming image resolution and the size to be printed on the screen. Here you can see the Y position maximum minimum defined. Why do I need this? Also, the position of the Y is minus 52. What does this mean too? Let's go to loop and look at the part where the image is drawing. It says that draw the JPEG image at X minus 30 and Y minus 52. What is that? This is because the incoming resolution is bigger, so we need to cut it and show it. The lowest resolution in ESP32 cam is QVGA, which is 320 by 240. ESP32 cam is currently set with QVGA. On the other hand, T-Display in landscape mode has a resolution of 240 by 135. Unfortunately, there is no way to reduce the size of JPEG image itself. So, the way I thought is to show the center of the image of JPEG that came in. I thought this was the most effective way for now. To show the center of the image, it was necessary to find a new starting point through simple calculations although it was not visible. By simply calculating the margin on the both sides of the horizontal and vertical size, the starting points minus 30 and minus 52 were correct. When drawing an image with TJPEG decoder, the decimal point was discarded because only integers are valid. Back to the code, let's look at the bottom part. I thought it would be good for it to move up and down the screen using two buttons. So if we press the right button, add the value of the Y position, and vice versa, press the left button to subtract the value of the Y position. By doing this, the height of the JPEG can be covered. Regarding the left and right movement, I didn't do it because I didn't have a good idea for the user interface. One thing about the button event, the reason why the button's events are not pressed well is that there are many tasks in the loop, so there's a problem with the button events being occurred. Maybe we can fix it in the upgraded version later. Let me upload this code and see the result. Here you are. On the right side, you can see how TTGO's display is coming out. The screen shows the current status in the text. It's not particularly meaningful because it's all predefined within ESP32CAM. This is just showing it's ready to go. Now let me connect power to the ESP32CAM. This source code is from my video series ESP32CAM Part 5. Please refer to it. After connecting, there is a slight delay. There seems to be some network delay after connecting to WebSocket. If you look at the serial monitor on the left, you can see how long it takes to draw one image. It's about 65 milliseconds on average, and this is excellent. Although this value does not include network transfer time, I'm sure there will be better results if we work on the network part and the image drawing part separately. I think it's time to wrap up today's project. TTGO as a server, it was possible to receive images from the client and output it on the built-in screen. Also, there are many things to update. Reconnecting when WebSocket is disconnected, reducing the network delay, task-based programming, and so on. Anyway, if I have a chance, I will prepare the upgrade version. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.